Cyrus Fees, MMA Inside the Cage here at UFC 145, and I am sitting next to the voice of the Octagon, a guy I look up to, Mr. Bruce Buffer. Bruce, you're here in Atlanta. There's a lot of electricity going all over this city, man. Atlanta is hotter than it's ever been when UFC comes to town. Just kind of talk about the hype and how the community's handling it and just what you're seeing out there.
You know, it's every UFC is extremely exciting wherever we go. One thing is the build-up to this event, with the build-up to Jones and Rashad. Yeah. Call it bad blood, call it good blood, call it whatever you want to call it. It's a build-up, and the city of Atlanta is embracing this strongly. I notice that when I'm out, it seems like everybody is aware of this fight, even landing at the airport. So the hum is high, and it should be, because it's going to be a hugely tremendous event tonight.
You know, you've been in the Octagon. You've called so many of these fights and announced for so many of these fights. What other rivalries can you think of that can rival this? Where this is at right now, with these guys, where this has been building for, what, almost 2 years now, and the friendship that they had, you know, whether they say they were friends or not, you know, these guys were friends, you know. What can you even equate this to?
I think the perfect example of rivalry would have been the Tito Ortiz-Chuck Liddell rivalry, because you got to remember that Tito and Chuck trained together. And I remember I was at John McCarthy's birthday in California, where they were training one time, and they came down from Big Bear to go to John's birthday. And I'm sitting with Tito, I'm sitting with Chuck, I'm sitting with John, and we're all the brothers that we always are and still today are. But I look back and remember how friendly Tito and Chuck were at that time, and then it turned into the rivalry that it turned into them. Yeah. Same thing. But you know what? The bottom line is these guys are pros. They're warriors. They're going to fight tonight. I'd be very surprised if at the end of this fight, no matter what the outcome, it's the usual good, you know, bro hug and thanks, we did it, on to the next. Because they're professionals.
Well, you know, we were at the weigh-ins, and the reception that that both Jones and Evans, you know, Evans has kind of gotten a mixed reaction, and now Jones got a real mixed reaction at the weigh-ins. Well, it was a lot of boos. It was a very mixed reaction for Jon Jones, which is something I hadn't really seen. Do you think it's how he's being represented? What do you think that is? How do you think the crowd would switch up like that?
You know, I really can't comment because I wasn't there, and I haven't really seen Jon ever get booed.
Yeah, it was something else.
I mean, I know that Rashad is from Delray, Florida. Delray Beach, I think it is.
Yes.
And maybe a lot of his hometown people or just took that short drive up here versus coming down from New York. I really couldn't answer that. It could also be due to the primetime shows, which I didn't see the last one because I've been traveling so much, obviously. But whatever that's creating is causing the brouhaha. I can't comment. I don't know.
Okay.
Well, obviously, you know, I can see here on the shirt, it's Time Industries. You have a new clothing line coming out you told me about, and of course, based on your catchphrase there in the cage, and just talk a little bit about what you're doing there with It's Time and everything that's going on.
Thanks, appreciate it. Well, you know, a lot of clothing companies come and go. A lot of companies come and stay. So I've analyzed all the companies out there, and I took the most marketable, most successful companies, and my partner and I, who I'm going to keep silent at this point, because he's one of the biggest people ever to be in the clothing industry, bigger than Tap Out, bigger than you name it, and sold well over $1 billion in clothes. So he is a huge fan of the UFC, and he thinks It's Time, as I do, could be the next Just Do It.
It's
right?
Time.
It's Time. So right now what we're doing is we're launching It's Time Industries, what we call ITI. And it's going to be everything from, you name it. I mean, it's going to be the clothes initially, the pants, the outfits, the shoes, the handbags, the belts, and eventually something I've always wanted to do, which is a suit line, where I'll have your suits tailored, handmade, delivered to you within 5 weeks. And this is all a big, not a dream, it was a dream, now it's a reality. Just in the next booth, you were here, we were having a meeting where we were going over all the initial clothes we're going to come out with. But again, you'll hear about it, you'll hear a lot about it, you'll see athletes, entertainment people, everybody wearing it, but I'm not going to have a thing sold in this country till probably the end of the year.
Okay.
Just going to do marketing.
Sure.
Do it right.
That is the way to do it. Now, I would be honored to wear an It's Time suit when I'm in there announcing in the cage myself. Speaking of which, you know, I've reached out to you, this was years ago, and I reached out to you and you kind of gave me advice. Talk to some of the other announcers, some of the other people that get into the game, that want to do that side of the game, get in there announcing, commentating. What advice would you give to somebody like that that's you know, trying to aspire to do something like that?
Well, first off, I wish everybody that wants to do it good luck, because I'd be the first one to support you. I give everybody credit for getting an arena, whether it's a stage, a ring, a cage, and standing in front of hundreds, if not thousands of people, and playing Simon Says, as I always call it. It's like Simon Says, right? Stand up, yell, scream. You all deserve credit. But the big thing and the most important thing I can tell you, and certainly if anybody's been a victim of potential criticism, which I avoided because I never wanted to, is develop your own style. Don't copy me. Don't copy the great Michael Buffer, my brother. I never wanted to copy my brother. I never wanted to be Frank Sinatra Jr. I told myself, if I'm going to go into this, I'm going to develop my own style. I cannot bar any genetic similarities because that's impossible, but the bottom line is create your own style, stand out as an individual, have a lot of fun, because if you're not having fun, don't even do it, right? Have passion for what you do. And the biggest thing is to try and get as many jobs as you can within your geographical area. I don't care if you start out, you do for free, sitting behind a table commenting on a high school basketball game. Get your resume built, get your voice experience in, and develop your own style. And then if there are people with fight organizations in your area, once you have that kind of material, submit your resume, submit your pictures, and try and get a job as an announcer. Now, I will tell you that if you think that there's huge money in this game, I am happy to say that my brother and I are, you know, do very, very well. I mean, we're able to make full-time incomes at this, even though I have various other businesses. But it's the type of situation that you have to understand you're not going to be able to retire from your day job. So don't quit your day job, but definitely you'll have a lot of fun at night and weekends and everything else. And then eventually maybe you get the right organization, you will get to the point, and I hope you do, that you can live off that for your work. But there's only a handful of people that can do that in this business. And you understand that too.
I surely do. Yeah.
Any place that they should visit, any website, anything you want to throw out before we get out of here?
Yeah, if you'd like to learn more about me or listen to my radio show, It's Time Radio, which is a podcast. It's basically UFC, sex, drugs, and rock and roll. We talk about everything, okay? I'm not just your basic MMA talk show, because there's so many good shows out there. I wanted to mix it up a little bit. And that's on the Sure Dog Radio Network. But my site is bufferzone.net. You can write me. I actually have a program where I do recordings for weddings and birthdays, and I've done like something like 65 weddings in the last like 6 months. And I've been paid a lot of money to do those, but I decided, you know, these fans, they're so great. I made it very inexpensive because this is your special day. I don't want you giving me your money that you should be spending on somebody else. But if you go to the YouTube, you'll see Bruce Buffer and weddings, and I get tears in my eyes seeing how happy these people are that I've been able to do this for them, because it means a lot to me. So that stuff, and also the Buffer Zone app will be out soon. I've had hundreds and thousands of requests for alarm clocks, right? Well, God bless the UFC, but they never created one. So what I'm going to do is I am doing it now. We're making a really incredible app. It's not just going to have alarms. It's going to have wake-up calls. It's going to be like, it's time to feed the dog. You know, it's like whatever the case might be. You'll have it all there for you. And that's coming out in a month.
Oh, there it is.
Yeah.
Bruce Buffer, the voice of the Octagon, right here, UFC 145 in Atlanta, Georgia.
May the best man win.